Last year, Elon Musk highlighted Tesla's plan to build a beast of a neural network training supercomputer. The supercomputer is being used to train Tesla's Autopilot and full self-driving FSD artificial intelligence. The new, which is the fifth most powerful computer in the world, will be the predecessor of the upcoming Tesla supercomputer called the Dojo. The computer is allowing the electric carmaker to solve the problem of designing a reliable self-driving system that uses only cameras, dispensing with radar and lidar. Want to know about it? Well, stay tuned to the video and watch the video till the end. Hello guys, welcome to the Elon Musk exclusive. Hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications to get new updates about technology and development and basically anything around real Tony Stark, Elon Musk. Hit the like button to show your support, and in today's video, we're going to discuss It Happened, Elon Musk Finally Reveals Quantum Computer 2022, so without any further ado, let's begin. Since 2019, Tesla CEO Elon Musk has periodically tweeted about Dojo, a neural network exaflop supercomputer. However, while that system is still in development, the automotive company discussed a powerful precursor system it uses for autonomous vehicle training. The heart of the design is the Dojo D1 chip, which provides stunning bandwidth and computes performance. Tesla found existing computer platforms lacking for their primary problem to solve, developing self-driving technology by training its massive neural networks, but they also hinted that they might provide Dojo to others developing AI in the near future. The company has developed other supercomputers on its way to Dojo, and now Andrej Karpathy, Tesla's head of AI, has unveiled the latest one during a presentation at the 2021 Conference on Computer Vision and Pattern Recognition. During the presentation, Karpathy gave a shout-out to Tesla's supercomputing team and showcased their latest work. "I want to briefly give a plug to this insane supercomputer that we're building and using now," Karpathy said. As he explained, the cluster, if it has a name, Karpathy didn't share it with the audience, sports 720 nodes, each powered by 8 of NVIDIA's A100 GPUs, the 80GB model, for a whopping 5,760 A100s throughout the system. The accelerator firepower is complemented by 10 petabytes of hot-tier NVMe storage, which has a transfer rate of 1.6 terabytes per second. Karpathy said that this incredibly fast storage constitutes one of the world's fastest file systems. "So this is a massive supercomputer," Karpathy said. "I actually believe that in terms of flops, this is roughly the number of 5 supercomputer in the world, so it's actually a fairly significant computer here." The new machine is Tesla's third supercomputer cluster and will no doubt teach the team at Tesla some valuable lessons ahead of its Dojo project release, which Musk has previously teased for this year. During his presentation, Karpathy said that he wanted to give a plug to his insane supercomputer that we're building and using now. He also stated that computer vision is the bread and butter of what we do and what enables Autopilot. The supercomputer will be used to train Tesla's Autopilot and its full self-driving FSD AI on vast amounts of data at incredibly high speeds, with Karpathy saying this requires a huge amount of computing. Karpathy didn't reveal any information on the Dojo project itself, though he did suggest it will handsomely outperform Tesla's latest machine. Seeing as Musk has stated Tesla will allow other companies to use the Dojo computer to train their neural nets, that's great news for autonomous driving. Most autopilot systems use a mixture of cameras, radar, and lidar to build as holistic and reliable a picture of the car's surroundings as possible. Tesla itself has traditionally used radars and cameras, not lidar. But last year, Tesla confirmed it would begin overhauling the autopilot system in its Model 3 and Model Y cars immediately, ditching radar in favor of an entirely camera-based system. Speaking at the 2021 Conference on Computer Vision and Pattern Recognition, Andrej Karpathy said, "Cameras were now surging ahead of radar, meaning the latter were beginning to act as a drag. Vision is getting to the point where the sensor is like 100 times better than, say, radar," he said. "If you have a sensor that is dominating the other sensor and is so much better, then the other sensor is actually holding you back and is actually starting to contribute noise. So we're really doubling down on the vision-only approach. The reason people are squeamish about using vision and the challenge that almost always is pointed out is that people are not certain if neural networks are able to do range finding or depth estimation of these objects." He said humans were able to use a purely visual system to do depth estimation. The question was whether computers could use cameras to do the same. He said that this answer was an unequivocal yes. He said the key to developing a purely vision-based autopilot rested on advanced capabilities in 3 areas: depth, velocity, and acceleration. To achieve this, he said a large, clean, and diverse dataset was needed. Existing supercomputers are more general purpose than Dojo. HPC, high-performance computing, another name for supercomputers, are optimized for very complex mathematical models of physical problems or designs, such as climate cosmology, nuclear weapons, and nuclear reactors. Novel chemical and material compounds, support for pharmaceutical research, and cryptology. Just for historical reference, the first supercomputer was the 1964 Control Data Corporation 6600, capable of executing 3 million floating point operations per second. Flops. Fast forward to 2020 and the PlayStation 5 has hardware capable of up to 10.28 teraflops, roughly 3 million times faster. But the fastest supercomputer today is clocked at 450 petaflops, 10,000 times faster than the PlayStation, and Tesla claims Dojo will reach exascale, an exaflop is 1 quintillion, double precision floating point operations per second. There's also some controversy about how Dojo is measured. According to the top 500 list compiled twice per year, Fugaku in Kobe, Japan, holds the number one as the undisputed fastest supercomputer in the world with a demonstrated 442 petaflops. It's widely believed that Fugaku is just getting started and could exceed an exaflop in its current configuration. This is a staggering 3 times faster than the number 2 entrant Summit at the Oak Ridge Laboratory in Tennessee, with a top speed of 149 petaflops. Dojo, with its 68.75 petaflops approximately, would then be in 6th place. Because the next 3 supercomputers are pretty close at 61.4 to 64.59 petaflops, Dojo may be in 7th, 8th, or even 9th place. The top supercomputers today cost $500 million or more, often taking 2 5,000-square-foot buildings. They're designed to process very complex mathematical calculations at scale, so it wouldn't make sense to build for a single application. While the top 10 or so are devoted to defense and intelligence applications, at least a third of them on the top 500 list are dedicated to healthcare, and many support crucial drug-related research. There are 2 supercomputers that are used in a private enterprise setting, one in an oil and gas-related study. It's no secret that most of the most powerful ones are used for nuclear weapons research and cybersecurity in the US, EU, Russia, China, and possibly others, although it has been made available for studying COVID-19. HPC Wire calculates that previous benchmarking of A100 performance on NVIDIA's own 63 petaflops Selene supercomputer means 720 sets of 8 A100 nodes could yield around 81.6 LINPACK petaflops, which would place the machine 5th on the most recent top 500 list. For now, though, Tesla is content to let the world know that it's betting big on HPC and that the bets are only getting bigger. Carpathy said that the HPC team is growing a lot and encouraged audience members who are excited by HPC applications and self-driving cars to reach out to the company. Much of the supercomputing work the company is doing is around fully autonomous driving. Little is known about the mysterious forthcoming system beyond a handful of tweets by Musk referencing the exaflop target, claiming that Dojo uses our own chips and a computer architecture optimized for neural net training, not a GPU cluster, and sharing that Dojo will be available as a web service for model training once we work out the bugs. The Tesla engineer didn't want to elaborate on Project Dojo, but he did say that it will be an even better supercomputer optimized for neural net training than Tesla's current cluster. Carpathy said work is still ongoing on Project Dojo, but the company isn't ready to reveal any more details. Musk has previously said that the system would use chips and computing architecture developed in-house and optimized for neural net training and will not use a GPU cluster. Whether Tesla was able to produce such a powerful computer is not nearly as interesting as what they intend to do with it. It remains to be seen if Dojo is a new architecture for supercomputers, exceeding the characteristics of the current ones in production, or a one-off device for their application. We don't know just how clever Dojo is yet. Now that we've come to the end of this video, I want to thank you for sticking with me, and I'd love to know what you think of it. Just comment down below. Also, if you like this video, make sure you like it and stay safe. Today's video is over, but if you want to see more, there's one on your screen right now, and there are a few more fun videos coming soon without everyday technology. I'll see you in the next video.